The law of conservation of mass says that when we have a chemical reaction, we need to have the same number of atoms on this side of the equation, on the reactant side, as we have on the product. Because mass can't be created or destroyed. So when we're balancing equations, we need to make sure we've got the same number of atoms. So we've seen a word equation so far. Now I'm going to show you how to write that as a chemical equation and then balance it. First of all, we need to be able to write the chemical symbols for the atoms on the molecules and get that right. So magnesium metal is just Mg. Now with oxygen, we need to remember that oxygen exists as two atoms of oxygen together, as O2. Then we have our arrow, so these are our reactants, and then on this side we've got one product. Now, we need to write this as the right formula. Okay, now, this is an ionic formula. Now, so you need to go back and remember how we do our crossing over. Okay, now, so magnesium is 2+. And we remember that from looking at our periodic table, or knowing that it's got two electrons in its outer shell. Oxygen is 2-. So when we cross these over, this 2 goes down here and this 2 goes down there. Remember, it's a ratio, so we can make that simplified and just make it MgO. So we don't actually have to do anything to this one. So I'm just going to give it a quick clean off. Okay, so we didn't have to do anything to this one in terms of the subscripts. But you need to be aware that there's no way you're going to be able to balance an equation correctly if you don't get your molecular formulas correct. Okay, so you need to do your crossing over, etc. Alright, so now what we do is we go through and have a look at each of the molecules on the reactant side and compare it to on the product side. So we've got one atom of magnesium here, and we've got one atom of magnesium here. So far, so good. But now we've got two oxygens on this side, on the reactant side, and only one on the product side. So that can't do. It's not balanced. So we need to do something here, so we've got the same number of oxygens on the product side as we have on the reactant side. There's only one thing we can do. We cannot ever put a 2 down here. Because if we did that, we would be changing the molecular formula. And it would no longer be magnesium oxide. So you must never do that. The only thing you can do is put a number in the front. And that's what we call a coefficient. So we've got two oxygen here and one oxygen here. What would we put here so that we've got two oxygen? So we put a 2 coefficient here. Now that means we've got two oxygens. Let's go back and check our magnesium. So this 2 means 2 magnesiums and 2 oxygens. So we've got 2 magnesium and 1 magnesium. So we need to put a coefficient here, 2 magnesium. And now our equation is balanced. We've got the same number of atoms on this side as we've got on that side.